there is a creature alive today who has survived millions of years of evolution without change, without passion, and without logic. It lives to kill. A mindless eating machine. It will attack and devour anything. It is as if God created the devil and gave him jaws. None of man's fantasies of evil can compare with the reality.
Police say that they have made a major corruption bust. We're waiting a news conference following the arrest of about 30 people, including two New Jersey mayors and several rabbis. Officials say some of the suspects charged today were selling human organs. The suspects were allegedly involved in taking cash payments to help find organs for patients in need of transplants. It is unclear where the body parts might have come from or how many surgeries may have been done, and we're hoping to get more information at that news conference in this hour. But for more on this, joining me now from Boston is Bill Gavin, an FBI veteran of 28 years and a former assistant director of the agency's New York office. And from Philadelphia, Dr. Arthur Kaplan, director of the Center for Bioethics at the University of Pennsylvania and, interestingly, co-chair of the UN Task Force on Human Trafficking. And from Washington, D.C., Dr. Bernadine Healy, health editor for U.S. News and World Report. Bill, I'd like to start with you. Reports right now that 30 people have been arrested, including a couple of mayors, deputy mayors, rabbis, state assemblymen. It certainly sounds like a very large dragnet.
There's no doubt about it. It is a large dragnet. The case has been ongoing for a couple of years now, and there's obviously cooperating witnesses involved in this. I've read both the complaints for a number of the individuals. Cooperating witnesses, I'm sure grand jury involvement. I'm also sure that there were overhears on telephones from Title III's. So it's going to be a far-reaching case, and some of these individuals are going to end up in jail. There's no doubt that they took money, and they have that recorded and have it taped pretty well at the same time.
I'd like to pause for a minute and bring in WNBC's Jonathan Deans, who's joining me on the phone. Jonathan's been following this very carefully this morning. Jonathan, can you give us some insight and an update? Jonathan Deans, are you there?
Yes, I am. Can you hear me?
Yes, I sure can. Sure can. Can you go ahead and just tell us?
Yeah, McCauley is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, public corruption investigation in New Jersey state history in terms of numbers. There were dozens of arrests. At last count, we heard of 30 people in custody, more than 20 of them public officials, some of them mayors, as you just heard, from Secaucus, from Hoboken, lots of officials from Jersey City as well. So this is wide-ranging. But this investigation doesn't only include allegations of public corruption. It includes issues of money laundering by community leaders and rabbis in numerous communities. It also amazingly deals with the smuggling of body parts. There's talk now that, or among the charges, that one of the suspects was actually lining up the kidney donors overseas out of Israel, and then they were allegedly lying for needy patients that these were relatives, and then they would fool hospitals like Johns Hopkins in Baltimore or Robert Wood Johnson Medical Center in New Brunswick to try to get them to perform these operations. So there are more and more charges and more allegations coming up from this undercover operation that was started out as public corruption and then grew into money laundering and the smuggling of body parts.
And Jonathan, I just want to make sure we're looking at these suspects, these 30-plus people who may have been rounded up, but no indication at this point that these universities or these medical centers were at all in this game.
No, not at all. They were unknown. They were duped. Absolutely not. That, according to law enforcement, they are saying that these were the suspects, these middlemen who were trying to broker these deals between patients in need and folks overseas who were willing to donate a kidney for a lot of money. And that's just one angle. Again, that is separate and apart, and they stumbled upon that while they were investigating the allegations of corruption. And they had a confidential witness, a cooperating witness, who went in with tapes, with audio recordings, who assisted the FBI, posing as a developer, and he was the one allegedly making these payoffs to these mayors, to these council members, to these public officials, thousands of dollars at a time. And, this is 20-plus public officials in this case. And you remember, New Jersey in just the last few years has seen more than 100 public officials be convicted, be charged in connection with public corruption charges.
I'd like to bring in Art Kaplan for a second. Art, you have written so much about this. I mean, I keep thinking you can't make this stuff up. This is just unbelievable.
You can't make this stuff up. We have this task force at the UN that I co-chair on organ trafficking. We've known for some time that there is international money laundering going on. I fear that what we're going to see here is not trade in body parts, but trade in people to sell their organs. I'm very concerned that this is really a scandal. It's going to involve selling organs from living people. And what happens is you go somewhere, you find a poor person, you tell them you'll pay them some money. And then you move them on to a hospital and pretend as if you're a relative or a friend. So these are situations where we have to be tough about making sure we know who organ donors are when they come to hospitals. Hospitals try to do that. I think they may have to redouble those efforts. And it has to be clear nationally and internationally. Selling organs for profit is not good for patients, is not good for the donors. You don't get follow-up about what happens to them. And we really have to crack down. We're going to say that in our report in a couple of months. We've got to stop this international trade in body parts.
Bernadine, you have worn so many hats in your career, a physician, head of a medical center, head of the Red Cross, now as a journalist for U.S. News & World Report. Your thoughts on this?
Well, I think the important thing for the public to know is that it is illegal in this country to sell organs. So whatever international rules might be, that this is an illegal and somewhat chilling thing to do. We've had statutes for the longest time that have been supported by the medical community. That this could happen here in this country is so shocking that I have to add one word of caution. Make sure that we get the facts before we really say that this is happening. I mean, it's so astoundingly awful, Nancy.
Right. Bill, you said something that I thought was so fascinating, that this has been in the works for years. Are these investigations that usually start looking at a flow of money and then investigators stumble in to sort of, the meat of the whole thing?
Yeah, Nancy, you're right. That's what happens. It probably started as a public corruption case with the individuals in New Jersey, and then it keeps blossoming from that. You overhears on telephones and things like that. This is going to take have a triple effect. It's going to do the public corruption, the money laundering. I think is going to be big, and then the harvesting of human organs is just absolutely irresponsible and diabolical. I think.
And Bill, really quickly, if this had been an investigation for years, what then is the trigger point to make the authorities say, okay, now we're moving in and we're getting in, at least, arrest these guys and throw up some indictments?
There's a couple of things that can do that, Nancy. It can be personal risk for individuals involved. It can also reach a point where something illegal, well, it's all illegal, but something drastic is going to be done that could actually harm an individual, and it might have to just reach that point where they say, we have to end this right now. They have a big dragnet and 30 people.
Sordid, awful, and unfortunately undermines all the good transplant programs and all the other information out there. So we will keep following this, and my appreciation to all
I am Dracula. I bid you welcome.